السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين، والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء المرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ليس عليكم جناح أن تأكلوا جميعا واشتاتا، صدق الله مولانا العظيم. صلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله.
صلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله.
صلاة والسلام عليك يا حبيب الله.
صلاة والسلام عليك يا نبي الله.
وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا نور الله صلى الله تعالى عليك وسلم. Alhamdulillah, in this week's Ijtima, we are going to learn the life, the works, the karama, the excellences of Khwaja Ghareeb Nawaz radiallahu ta'ala anhu. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevate his status. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shower infinite blessings on his grave. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ability to follow his teachings. Ameen. Those who were present last week, we talked about Urs in the light of Quranic verses and hadith of Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. And I mentioned one thing that is observed during Aras. The Mazharat of the Awliya is that many people that come to seek blessings of the Awliya and the Ghuraba, the Masakeen, the poor people, they come and they eat from the Niyaz, from the food that has been distributed at the Mazhar of the Awliya. Inshallah, today I would like to go through one of the risala, one of the books of Sayyidina Ala Hazrat radiallahu ta'ala anhu.
Subhanallah.
Talking about the excellences of sadaqah, charity, and especially feeding other Muslim brothers or sisters. Now this book, the name of the book is Radul Qahti Wal Waba Bida'wat Al-Jiran Mawasat Al-Fuqara. And this book can be found in the 23rd volume of Fatawa Ridwa Sharif, inshallah. The questioner asked a question regarding certain individuals in part of India, that it is their custom, their ritual, their tradition, their habits, that whenever they're afflicted with any calamity, famine, drought, disease, what they would do, the rich people will come together and they will make the food and give it to the ulama, to the citizens, and especially to the ghuraba, to the poor people. Ala Hazratullah ta'ala anhu was asked whether this is permissible in the light of Sharia. Now you're going to understand why Ala Hazrat is Ala Hazrat, not an ordinary Hazrat. The in-depth knowledge he has, and how he tackles this question, and he gives a satisfactory answer to the question, is unbelievable.
SubhanAllah.
Ala radiallahu ta'ala anhu, after a very short khutbah, he mentions the first verse. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Laysa alaykum junahun, there is no harm upon you. And ta'akulu jami'an, that you eat together, or ashtata, or individually. From this verse, there's no harm if people come together to eat the food, or they can eat individually, in the light of the verse. Then Ala radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he says, now this is the wording of Ala radiallahu ta'ala anhu, talking about feeding other people.
SubhanAllah.
Is feeding other people There are eight qualities, benefits, like the eight which are the doors of Jannah. Yes, eight in adad. He says, number one, فَزِيلَةِ صَدَقَةً. The virtue, the benefit of giving charity. Number two, خِدْمَةِ صَلَحًا. To serve the righteous and the pious people. Number three, صِلَةِ رَحَمٍ. To keep ties with your relatives, to look after them. Number four, مُوَاسَاتِ جَارٍ. To look after your neighbors. Number five, سلوک نیک سے مسلمانوں خصوصا غربا کا دل خوش کرنا. I to make the heart of the believers, especially the poor people, filled with happiness. To fill someone's heart with happiness. چھے, ان کی مرغوب چیزیں ان کے لئے مہیا کرنا. To provide them with food which they like, which they desire. Number seven, مسلمان بھائیوں کو کھانا دینا. To feed the Muslim brothers. And number eight, مسلمانوں کا کھانے پر مشتمل ہونا. The Muslims, the believers, to gather on a feast. These are the eight virtues of feeding the Muslims in, for example, in a town, in a village, in India. And then Anas radiallahu ta'ala anhu, very beautifully, he goes through many, many ahadith to illustrate to us the importance of giving charity and feeding other people. And this is, subhanAllah, some very amazing, beautiful ahadith. Now, before we go through the ahadith, try to view the life of Khwaja ibn Nawaz radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the life of the awliya, in the light of this ahadith. And try to understand what was the reason that today we love Khwaja ibn Nawaz radiallahu ta'ala anhu. It is only because khidmati khalq, serving the creation of Allah
subhanahu.
And try to understand the virtue, the excellence and reward of those individuals who go out to serve the people, Muslims and also non-Muslims. Yes. This is what Islam teaches us. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. So the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, he narrates, إِنَّ صَدَقَةَ لَتُطْفِئُ غَضَبَ الرَّبِّ وَتَدْفَعُ مَيْتَةَ السُّوءِ. Indeed, giving charity extinguish the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it elevates or stops, prevents fatal death, bad death, accidental death. مَيْتَةَ السُّوءِ. This is one of the virtues. In another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala wa sallam said, اِتَّقُ النَّارِ. Stay away from hellfire. Don't fall into the depths of hellfire, into the fire. وَلَوْ بِشِقِّ تَمْرَةٍ. Even by giving half the date as charity. Abstain, stay away from Jahannam by giving charity, even if it's equal to half a date. فَإِنَّهَا تُقِيمُ الْعِوَجِ. Because charity, it straightens those things which are crooked. وَتَدْفَعُ مَيْتَةَ السُّوءِ. And it prevents bad death, evil death. Another beautiful benefit of giving sadaqah. إِنَّ صَدَقَةَ الْمُسْلِمِ. Indeed, the charity of a believer, تَزِيدُ فِي الْعُمَرِ. Increases your lifespan. وَتَمْنَعُ مَيْتَةَ السُّوءِ. Again, it prevents fatal death, accidental death. Another beautiful hadith, As-sadaqatu tutifi'u al-khati'ata. Indeed, giving charity, it removes sins. وَتَقِي مَيْتَةَ السُّوءِ. And it prevents fatal accidents. Subhanallah. And look at this. The Prophet sallallahu ta'ala said, As-sadaqatu tasaddu وَتَسُدُّ سَبْعِينَ بَابًا مِّنَ السُّوءِ. That indeed, sadaqah, it prevents or closes 70 doors of misfortunes. Giving charity closes 70 doors of misfortune, calamities, diseases, problems. And to explain this further, in another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, أَصَدَقَةُ تمنع 70 نوعا من أنواع البلاء. Indeed, charity prevents 70 types of calamities. أهونها الجذام والبرص. The least of this calamity is leprosy. Okay, the least, the lightest, أهون of this calamity is leprosy. I imagine the 70th one at the top. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam also says, "Bakiru bi sadaqah." Give sadaqah in early morning. When you wake up, before you leave your houses, give sadaqah. فَإِنَّ الْبَلَاءَ لَا يَخَطَّهَا. Because bala, calamity, will not suppress it. Will not overcome it. When you give sadaqah, it will be a shield from all calamities. وَالصَّدَقَاتُ بِالْغَدَوَاتِ يَذَهَبْنَ بِالْعَاهَاتِ. Giving charity in early mornings takes away misfortunes, diseases. وَالصَّدَقَةُ تَمْنَعُ الْقَضَاءَ سُوءٍ. And charity, it prevents evil fate, bad fate, destiny. If you're destined that this will happen to you, an accident for example, that's why the ulama they have stated, if you're traveling, whether it's a short journey or a long journey, try to give a few pounds of sadaqah, because this will prevent any from any accidents. The Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam says, صَلُوا الَّذِي بَيْنَكُمْ وَبَيْنَ رَبِّكُمْ بِكَثْرِ ذِكْرُكُمْ لَهُ. Try to reconnect or connect yourself with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by mentioning Him a lot, doing His dhikr a lot. وَكَثْرَةِ الصَّدَقَةِ. And giving charity a lot. بِالسِّرِّ وَالْعَلَانِيَةِ. Secretly, hiddenly, and openly. What will happen? Three things will happen. تُرُزَقُوا. You'll be given sustenance. وَتُنْصَرُوا. You'll be supported by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَتُجْبَرُوا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will straighten your affairs. Yes? He will look after your affairs. And, subhanallah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, مَثَلُ الْمُؤْمِنِ وَمَثَلُ الْإِيمَانِ. An example of a believer and an example of faith, iman, is like what? كَمَثَلِ الْفَرَسِ. Is an example like a horse. فِي أَخْبِئَتِهِ. The horse which is in its stable, in its tent. أَخْبِئَ the past. Okay, they didn't have stable, just to have tents. Just to keep animals and sheep and horses there. يَجُولُ. That this horse goes out to eat. ثُمَّ يَرْجِعْ إِلَىٰ أَخْبِئَتِهِ. And then this horse comes back to its tent, to its stable. وَإِنَّ الْمُؤْمِنِ. Indeed a believer. Yes, who makes errors. You go out in life, you make errors. Okay, then what happened? ثُمَّ يَرْجِعْ إِلَىٰ الْإِيمَانِ. This believer who believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will repent, feel remorseful, and he will return back to iman. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, فَأَطْعِمُوا طَعَامَكُمُ الْأَتْقِيَاءِ. Then feed your food to the righteous people. When you keep da'wahs at your houses, in-laws are invited. Yes, your friends are invited. But at the same time, the Prophet says, أَطْعِمُوا طَعَامَكُمُ الْأَتْقِيَاءِ. Let your righteous people eat your food. The pious people. Yes. وَلَّوْ مَعَرُوفَكُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. And treat other Muslims well. Yes. And now, two things now the Prophet mentions. Especially in our culture, our youth are forgetting this. The Prophet says, إِنَّ صَدَقَةَ وَسِلَةُ الرَّحِمِ. Indeed, giving charity and keeping ties with your relatives, looking after them. يَزِيدُ اللَّهُ بِهِمَا فِي الْعُمَرِ. Allah increase because of these two your age. Lifespan will give you barakah in your life. وَيَدْفَعُ بِهِمَا مَيْتَةَ السُّوءِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will prevent from these two fatal deaths. Subhanallah. مَنْ أَحَبَّ أَنْ يَبْسُطَ لَهُ فِي رِزْقِهِ وَيَنْسَأَ لَهُ فِي أَثَرِهِ فَلْيَسِرْ رَحِمَهُ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, those who love that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives barakah or expands his sustenance, his risk, his wealth, فليصل رحمه, then you should look after your relatives, your cousins, your uncles, your grandparents, yeah, your in-laws. All these are from your silatul rahim. You have to look after them. And looking after your relatives, yes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give barakah in your life. Yes, and that's why the old people, age of 80, 90, 100, is because they've always looked after their relatives. From very young age. Okay, from very young age, they always looked after their relatives. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, مَنْ سَرَّهُ أَنْ يَمُدَّ أَوْ يُمَدَّ لَهُ فِي عُمْرِهِ وَيُوسَعُ لَهُ فِي رِزْقِهِ وَيُدْفَعُ عَنْهُ مَيْتَ السُّوءِ فَلْيَتَّقِ اللَّهِ وَلْيَسِرْ رَحِمَهُ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, those who want to expand their lifespan, those who want blessings in their lifespan, or those and those who want to prevent themselves from bad ending, fatal death, فَلْيَتَّقِ اللَّهِ, then first thing he should fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَلْيَسِرْ رَحِمَهُ, and he should look after his relatives. Yes, أَبُشْنَيْ بَهِنْجِنَا. These are hadith of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yes. Subhanallah. Yes, another beautiful hadith of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. إِنَّ أَعْجَدَ الْبِرِّ ثَوَابًا. The Prophet says, the quickest way to earn rewards. Okay, you must be thinking praying namaz. Yes, keeping fasts. Spending all day and all night in worship. No. Okay, the Prophet says, إِنَّ أَعْجَلَ الْبِرِّ ثَوَابًا. The quickest way to earn reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is صِلَةِ الرَّحِمِ, by looking after relatives. And this is, in this, unfortunately, in this Western culture, our youth are forgetting this. Okay, want to confine our own families, yeah? Close family, forget the uncles, the cousins, aunts, and innies and nephews. You just want to stay with your own family, no. Okay? You should spread your mercy, your blessing to everyone. إن أهل البيت ليكونوا فجرة. Even though your relatives, they are transgressors. They're sinners, open sinners. Look after them. فتنمو, what will happen if you do that? فتنمو أموالهم, your wealth will grow. Huh? Your coins will grow, that literally will come, but they'll be blessings. Okay? ويكثروا عددهم, and your number will increase. You get barakah in your children. Now, this is another thing that we don't want to do. إذا تواصلوا, if you look after. Yes. If you look after each other, if you look after your relatives, Allah, this, all these ahadith, okay, giving you wazifa of how to increase your wealth on barakah. Yes. No debt. There'll be barakah, inshallah. And that is why, talking about debt, yeah, the Prophet says, وَمَا مِنْ أَهْلِ بَيْتٍ يَتَوَاصَلُونَ وَيَحْتَاجُونَ. That if a household looks after another household, by looking after other relatives, they will be never in need of anyone. Okay, Allah will suffice them. Okay, and then another three things. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Silatul rahimi, looking after your relatives, wa husnul khuluqi, having good character, having good manners." وَحُسْنُ الْجَوَارِ, and looking after your neighbors. يَعْمُونَ الدِّيَارِ, what will happen? If these three things will happen in a city, in a village for example, then what will happen? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will inhabit that or flourish that city. There will be barakah in that city. وَيَزِدْنَا فِي الْعَمَارِ, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will increase their age. SubhanAllah. Okay, if you go, you know, most of the people in China, look at their average lifespan, 80, 90. Okay, the reason I was, you know, this correspondent, BBC correspondent, she asked the question, why? She went there, she saw one thing, everyone's smiling. Yeah? Everyone's smiling. Yeah. So this is what husnul khuluq, having good character, having good manners. And a beautiful hadith, the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, sana'iul ma'aruf, doing good actions, neg amal, taqi masali as-su will prevent calamities and problems. Wa sadaqatu khafiyyan, and giving charity hiddenly, secretly, not that hadith sabi darab say 5 pounds. Okay, and if we tell Imam sir, forgot to mention a name, Azat, I'm not happy with you. Why? You forgot to mention my name? Okay, the reward has not reached my marhumin, my deceased. They think that just if the Imam mentions a name, that's the only time the thawab will be given to the deceased. No. Okay, khafiyyan, hidden, secretly. What will happen? Tutfi'u ghadab al-Rabb. This will extinguish the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَصِلَةُ الرَّحَمِ. So this is about giving charity. وَصِلَةُ الرَّحَمِ, and to look after your time, looking after your relatives. زِيَادَةٌ فِي الْعُمَرِ, will increase your life, your lifespan. وَكُلُّ مَعَرُوفٍ, and then the Prophet says, generalize it. وَكُلُّ مَعَرُوفٍ صَدَقَةٌ. Every good thing is صَدَقَةٌ. Yeah, there's another hadith, even smiling to your Muslim brother is صَدَقَةٌ. You can smile back now, inshallah. You get the thawab. And then the Prophet says, وَأَهْلُ الْمَعَرُوفِ, those who do good of this dunya, في الدنيا, هُمْ أَهْلُ الْمَعَرُوفِ الْآخِرَةِ, they will see the reward in Akhirah. وَأَهْلُ الْمُنْكَرِ, and those who do bad, evil, sin in this dunya, هُمْ أَهْلُ الْمُنْكَرِ فِي الْآخِرَةِ, they will see the penalty of their actions and their judgment. وَأَوَّلُ مَنْ يَدْخُلُ الْجَنَّةِ أَهْلُ الْمَعَرُوفِ, and the first one who will enter Jannah will be those who do good. Yes. Look after your relatives. Look after your neighbors. إِنَّ مِنْ مُوجِبَاتِ الْمَغْفِرَةِ, things that will necessitate مَغْفِرَةِ, مُوجِبَاتِ, wajib, that your sins will be forgiven. مُوجِبَاتِ, أَوْجَبَ يُجِبِ إِجَابِ, for those reading Arabic. مُوجِب is مَفَعِل. Things that will necessitate مَغْفِرَةِ. Yes, you're listening. إِدْخَالُكَ السُّرُورُ عَلَىٰ أَخِيكَ الْمُسْلِمِ, to put delight, happiness in your brother's heart. If you make your brother happy, yes? If you make him happy with your actions, with your words, with your face, yeah? Then that this is مُجِبَاتُ الْمَغْفِرَةُ, means of you to be forgiven. Subhanallah. And that this is amazing. Okay, this hadith you remember till the last breath. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "أَحَبُّ الْعَمَالِ إِلَى اللَّهِ تَعَالَى بَعْدَ الْفَرَائِدِ." The most beloved action, the most beloved action after faraid, after all compulsory obligatory actions, after your salah, after your zakah, after your hajj, after your siyam, after sadaqah, after all the faraid. What? Understand? What is the most beloved action? أحب الأعمال إلى الله, in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إدخال السرور على المسلم, to place happiness in your brother.
Subhanallah.
Okay? No, blood brother, Muslim brothers. Okay, you're walking down the street in a car, okay, your brother is walking, give him a lift, make him happy. Okay, this is إدخال السرور. Yes, your brother is in debt. Okay, you're rich, give him some money, pay off. إِدْخَالُ السُّرُورُ. Yes. He's in hospital. Okay, go visit him. إِدْخَالُ السُّرُورُ. All these, you can think of all the ways of, you know, making others happy. And this is what Islam is. This is what Islam is, make everyone happy. أَفْضَلُ الْعَمَالِ, again another beautiful hadith. To reiterate the previous hadith. أَفْضَلُ الْعَمَالِ, the best actions. إدخال السرور على المؤمن, to give delight, happiness to your brother. كسوت عورته, how? One way is to cover his aura, giving him good clothes to wear. وأشبعت جوعته, to kill his hunger, feeding him. وقضيت له حاجة, and to fulfill his needs. Okay? To give someone good clothes, to kill his hunger, and to narrate takbir, narrate risalat, ulama ahli sunnah. Pray the Rishif, Allahumma salli ala sallamu ala Muhammad al-Mahdi al-Jumdi al-Karam al-Ali wa sahbihi wa barik wa sallim. Yes, so the best action in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to fill your brother's heart with happiness. Now another beautiful hadith of Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, مَنْ وَافَقَ مِنْ أَخِيهِ شَهْوَةً غُفِرَ لَهُ. Those who fulfill the permissible desires of a brother. Okay, let's say for example, I like, you know, in إِحَالْ عُلُومِ which I'm going to do it right at the end. If a brother likes a particular food, I like, for example, biryani. And say, okay, Maulana Hussein loves biryani, okay, I'm going to feed him biryani. Yes, شَهْوَةً desire. Halal desire. Okay? غُفِرَ لَهُ, you'll be forgiven. Allah will forgive you. Yes?
Subhanallah.
That's why another beautiful hadith. مَنْ أَطْعَمَ أَخَاهُ الْمُسْلِمْ شَهْوَتَهُ. Those who feed their Muslim brother the food which he desires. حَرَّمَهُ اللَّهُ عَلَى النَّارِ. Allah will make fire haram upon him. He will never enter hellfire. Just by feeding your brother the food he likes.
Yes.
Okay, this is all, you know, looking at the life of the awliya. وَمِنْ مُوجِبَاتِ الرَّحْمَةِ. Okay, مُوجِبَاتِ الرَّحْمَةِ, مُوجِبَ again. Things that necessitate rahmah, the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِدْعَامُ الْمُسْلِمِ الْمِسْكِينَ, to feed the poor Muslims. Feeding them. Okay, نِيَاز شَرِيف. Give whatever you can for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the reward of it. Yes? And then part of the long hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, الدرجات. Okay? Means of elevating status. إِفْشَاءُ salam, to spread salam. وَإِدْعَامُ الطَّعَامُ, to feed people. وَالصَّلَاةُ بِاللَّيْلِ وَالنَّاسُ نِيَامُ, and to pray your salah during the night when people are sleeping. Salatul Tahajjud. Inshallah, inshallah. Few hadith left, inshallah, we'll have an ad at the end, and then Salatul Maghrib, inshallah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, this is amazing. I mentioned this to you today. مَنْ عَطْعَمَ أَخَاهُ حَتَّى يُشْبِعَهُ. If a person fed his brother till he's full, وَسَقَاهُ مِنَ الْمَا حَتَّى يُرْوِيَهُ, or gave him water till he quenches thirst, بَاعَدَ اللَّهُ مِنَ النَّارِ سَبَى خَنَالِقَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will keep him away, distance him, a distance of 7 trenches, خندق. مَا بَيْنَ كُلِّ خَنْدَقَيْنِ مَصِيرَةُ 500 عَامٍ. And the distance between each trench is 500 years. Yeah, if you feed a brother till he's full, he quenches thirst. Approximately 3,500 years away, you'll be away from Jahannam. Yeah? And imagine if you feed thousands and thousands. Okay, what happens in Ajmer Sharif? إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَزَّ وَجَلْ يُبَاهِي مَلَائِكَتَهُ بِالَّذِينَ يُجْعِمُونَ الطَّعَامِ عَبِينِهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praises those individuals in front of the malaika, yubahi. He feels proud. Okay, he praises the individuals who feed their servants. Who feed other people. Okay, and when I read this hadith, I always remember Brother Mahmood. Subhanallah. Al-khayru asra'u ila al-bayt alladhi yukaru fi. The goodness is quicker to a household in which people eat. من الشفرة إلى سنام البعيد, than a blade that cuts the hump of a camel. Okay, I don't know how the camels are sacrificed. This is how they sacrifice. Okay, from the neck towards the hump. Okay? So the khair blessing will reach the household quicker than a knife that reaches the neck or the hump of a camel. Okay? In a house where people eat. Al-Malaikatu, the angels, تُصَلِّ عَلَىٰ أَحَدِكُمْ, always send blessings upon you. مَا دَامَتْ مَعِدَتُهُ مَوْضُوعَةً, as long as the food mat is spread in your houses. Yes, if you keep it spread in your houses, okay, the angel will keep sending blessings upon your household. الضَّيْفُ يَعْتِي بِرِزْقِهِ But also at the same time, remember, the guests, they come to your house with their own risk. Okay, the guests come, okay, with their own provisions, risk. Allah given you the ability to feed him because that risk was written for him. وَرَدَّحِلُوا بِذُنُوبِ الْقَوْمِ And he goes back taking away the sins of the people. Ay Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive the sins of those hosts who feed the guests. And this is subhanallah. The Prophet says, لَأَنْ أَطْعَمَ خَالِفِ اللَّهِ لُقْمَةً To give one morsel of food to my brothers for the sake of Allah. أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ مِنْ أَتَصَدَّقَ عَلَى مِسْكِينَ بِدَرْهَمٍ is more beloved to me than to give one dirham to miskeen. People say, you know, what's the point feeding these Muslims of England, for example, in Yaz time? Send those money to the poor people. The Prophet says, to feed one morsel of food to my brother, أَخَالِفِ اللَّهِ Okay, is more beloved to me than giving a dirham to a miskeen.
SubhanAllah.
وَلَأَنْ أُعْتِيَ خَالِفِ اللَّهِ دِرْهَمًا And to give one dirham to my brother أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ مِنْ أَتَصَدَّقَ عَلَى مِسْكِينَ بِمِئَةِ دِرْهَمٍ Is more beloved to me than to give 100 dirham to the poor people. Yeah? Say subhanallah.
Subhanallah.
Inshallah. لَأَنْ أَجْمَعَ نَفَرًا مِنْ أَخَوَانِي عَلَى سَاعٍ أَوْ سَاعَيْنْ مِنْ طَعَامٍ أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ مِنْ أَدْخُلَ سُوقَكُمْ فَأَشْتَنِي رَخَبَةً فَعَتِقُهَا The Prophet says, if I was to gather my brothers on food which is equal to one sa' or two sa'as, one sa' is equal to one and a half pounds, LV. Or two sa'as of food is more beloved to me than me going to your markets and buying one of the slaves and freeing him. This is more beloved. What? To feed my brothers and freeing a slave. The Prophet ﷺ was asked by the companions that we eat, but sometimes we cannot fulfill our hunger. Okay, we keep thinking we're hungry. So the Prophet ﷺ says, ask, do you eat individually or do you eat together? They said, the comment said, we eat individually. The Prophet ﷺ said, اجتمعوا على طعامكم Eat together your food. واذكروا اسم الله تعالى Then mention the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يُبَارِكُ لَكُمْ فِي Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give barakah to your food. كُلُوا جَمِيعًا Eat together. وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا Don't eat individually my own burger. Okay, on one corner of the room. This is your slice of pizza. Go. Together. كُلُوا جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا فَإِنَّ الْبَارَكَةَ مَعَ الْجَمَاعَةِ Because barakah is in jama'ah.
SubhanAllah.
When I started, it was only food. The jama'ah, you can see the best in this house. And then the ulama, nur ala nur. Al-barakatu fi thalatha. Barakah is in three things. Yeah, fi al-jama'ah.
Subhan.
Jama'ah, group. Wa thariq. Dino gujati churilu kawa. Mashallah, you all do that. Give me some in the kawa. So this is gujati, yeah. When you break the chapati roti and then you make a food, churilu. So there's barakah in three things. Fil jama'ati in jama'ah, wa thareed in thareed, wa suhoor and in sahri.
Subhanallah.
And the second last hadith. إِنَّ أَحَبُّ الطَّعَامِ إِلَى اللَّهِ تَعَالَى The best food in the sight of Allah subhanahu ma kathurat alayhi al-aydi in which many hands come. Okay, well, many people eat from. Okay, so small food, but it suffices many people. This is more beloved in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And just to finish off with one hadith, which I read in Ihya of Imam Ghazali radiallahu ta'ala anhu. This hadith has narrated by Saint Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Okay, this is the crux of all the dust of today, inshallah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever fulfills the desire of his brother, Imam Ghazali then states in brackets, by feeding the food which his brother desires, his favorite food, then what is the reward? Then Allah will give him 1 million rewards, will forgive 1 million of his sins, Quran will elevate 1 million of his statuses. And not only this, okay, the takmil of this hadith is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will feed him the food of Jannatul Firdaws, Jannatul Adn, or Jannatul Khuld. Okay? So this was from the book of Ali Hazrat radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and looking at the life of the awliya, this is what it is. Okay? Looking after the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, looking after the poor people. Okay? If Shaw Salam, spelling peace, Eid Amu Ta'am, feeding people, Husnul Khulq, having khuluq, having good manners. This is the means of seeking the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ability to follow the hadith of Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, inshaAllah.